Greetings, viewers. I am Double J Double M, Jeff John Mwana Mzalendo. I have a question for you today. In 1961, Kenya had a system of government that had a prime minister. However, in 1964, the position of prime minister was abolished in favor of a powerful president. Why? Again, between 2008 and 2013, we had a form of government that had a president, a vice president, a prime minister, and two deputy prime ministers. However, when we passed the 2010 constitution, the positions of a prime minister and the deputy were not included in the new government, and we instead got a powerful presidential system. Why? If you understand the answer as to why we keep experimenting with the positions of prime minister and a powerful presidency, then you will understand why we have hit at the wall with regards to the Building Bridges Initiative, or famously BBI. It is actually very simple why our problem as a country is that we keep amending the constitution based on the people who are in power or those that are looking for the same power. This is actually why the courts had a very easy time stopping the BBI, or in more relatable terms, stopping the reggae. However, I also agree with some aspects of the BBI, especially those concerned with creating a political system that ensures peaceful transfer of power and a peaceful elections. In my opinion, political power is best exercised through hardships. What do I mean? Look at our neighbors down here in Tanzania. They are not very tribalistic, but about half of the country is Christian, while the other half is Muslim. In other countries, such as with religious divides such as that, as the such religious divide becomes a source of conflicts that are endless and destruction of the country. Look at a very good example, the Central African Republic, where Muslims, that is the Seleka fighters, and the Christians and Tibalaka fighters, they have destroyed their country with wars that appear to be endless. Or even look at the Middle East, right now, or any other time in the history. But how have Tanzanians been able to stay peaceful across different presidential successions? Let me tell you their secret today. It is a sort of handshake between Christians and Muslims to share power in Tanzania. For example, Mwalimu Julius Nyerere was Christian, and he was the first president of that country. He handed over power to Ali Hassan Mwinyi, who was a Muslim. Ali Hassan Mwinyi then handed over power to Benjamin Mkapa, a Christian. And as well, Benjamin Mkapa passed the baton to Jakaya Kikwete, who was a Muslim. And Jakaya Kikwete was succeeded by John Pombe Magufuli, the late, who was a Christian. Do you see a pattern there? Through that kind of a pattern, you can easily and correctly guess the religion of the current president of Tanzania, Samia Suluhu, even without seeing her or even reading about her. Another example can be found in Nigeria. In Nigeria, also, the population is half Christian and half Muslim. So what happens is that within the political parties themselves, if the top candidate is Christian, then they go for the deputy to be a Muslim, and vice versa. That's why Olusegun Obasanjo, who is a Christian, was succeeded by Musa Yar Adua, a Muslim. Musa Yar Adua was succeeded by Jonathan Goodluck, a Christian. And the current president of Nigeria, Muhammadu Buhari, is a Muslim. And another pattern there can be seen. What am I saying? What I'm saying is that President Uhuru Kenyatta and his brother, the Right Honorable Raila Odinga, have a good story to tell with BBI, but they are telling it in a very bad way. They have a good product, the BBI, but they are selling it very poorly. It is true Kenya needs to have a hardship, yes, with itself, just like the examples that I've given of Tanzania and Nigeria. But the way BBI has been pushed so far is not the way to go about it. And this is not, in it is not me saying it. Even the courts, they just said it. They said the same when they stopped the reggae or the BBI. By the way, political compromises or handshakes are not necessarily new in Kenya. Such handshakes are actually happening elsewhere in the country. What you will notice in counties which have majority and minority tribes, or majority and minority clans, is that when the governor of the county is from a certain majority tribe or clan, the deputy then will likely be from the minority tribe or clan. True or false? An example is Migori County, where the governor, Okoth Obadu, is from the majority Luo tribe, while the deputy, Mr. Nelson Mahanga, is from the minority Kuria's. In Nakuru County, for example, the governor, Lee Kinyanjui, is a Kikuyu, and the deputy is a Kalenjin. While in northeastern Kenya, a lot of leadership positions are a product of negotiations, all hardships. These are handshakes among powerful or major clans and minor clans with the blessings of the elders. This is my appeal to our leaders. Handshakes are very important for peace and prosperity. Yes, but as you seek to shake our hands, don't come with twisted fists. Come with open palms. Viewers, talk to me. Do you think Kenya is ready for a negotiated leadership position? Is this the best path towards peaceful elections? Please share your thoughts on the comment section below here. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe to this channel, The Voice of Reason. I'm looking forward to your thoughts and comments. I remain JJM, Jeff John, Mwana Mzalendo. See you next time, and remember to stay safe. We are here on location at Mirema Country Grounds along Mirema Drive here in Roysambu. Bye-bye. See you next time. Adios.